Hello, everybody. It's Sandy from Operation Ride Home. Welcome to episode number 80. And I see there are people who were actually here early. Look at you guys. You're like way anxious to be here, which is awesome. I love that you have such enthusiasm for the show. And for those who don't stay up and watch it live, but watch it later religiously, thank you very much. And I wanted to celebrate something. I just looked in the little thing up above. I guess it's over there if you're watching this on YouTube. It's over there where I'm, anyway, left, right. We're at 999 subscribers. One more person needs to click that subscribe button. One more person. That's it. One more. So if you are new to us, please click the subscribe button that's up there. You will see it. If you hover over it, it gives you an option to be emailed with new uploads. So you will find out about it. So yay! We're going to probably be over 1,000 maybe. Really quick. And if you recall, I promised you a while back that when we hit 1,000 subscribers, I would do a cover of a Justin Bieber video. So guess what? If somebody else subscribes, I'm going to do that. I'm off work next week, and I'm going to be working like a laser focus, laser beam focus on the YouTube interactive project that I'm working on. But I will try to slide that one in, and I think it's actually going to help me get to the Justin Bieber thing. So yay, if we make it to 1,000, yes, exciting. I know, 1,000 is nothing on YouTube. There's people with millions of subscribers, but I'm happy with what little milestones we can cover. Anyway, if I forgot to introduce myself, I'm Sandy, president of Operation Ride Home. I'm glad to be your hostess of OWHTV. We are here each week, live Thursdays at 6:30 p.m. Pacific time. And next week is Thanksgiving Thursday, and so we are not going to have a show on Thanksgiving, obviously. But we're going to have a Black Friday special show. Keep an eye on the blog and on Facebook, and I will have a link for how you can get there. It's going to be like one of those, it's at a platform called Stage It, and it's like a dollar, you know, you just pay a little fee to get in, and that's it. It's not recorded, so you will not be able to see it later. It's just a one-time thing. So if you want to go and see the special show, I'm going to have, I don't know, I'll tell you more about it later when I figure it all out, but I'm going to have a special sketch and some teachings on how to use that sketch, maybe on matching pattern papers, that kind of thing, and might do some coloring. I don't know. Haven't really figured out completely what I'm going to do, but whatever it is, no one else will know about it if they're not there. So it's Black Friday, 2 o'clock Pacific in the afternoon. So hope you can join us. Let's see. Where's my list? I have a list. Yes. I told some people on Facebook that I went shopping today at lunch. And I went to... Dun, dun, dun! Look at that. I bought something at Hallmark. I haven't bought something at Hallmark in like 15 years. I've been walking around the store like, I don't even know where it is, what I'm looking for. I am going to do something special with what's in here, and I will do a video of it and share that with you at some point. But yes, I shopped at Hallmark. Anyway, but they did have something I wanted, so there you go. Let's see. Okay, so tonight's show, we are going to share some Hero Arts Valentine cards made with the OWH Hero Arts stamps. We are going to have Stump Sandy, but I wanted to proceed with episode 2 of this segment. Changes coming in 2013. Yes, how do you like that for a great and high-tech segment header? Yay, changes coming. Because 2013 is coming, and I like to refresh things at the new year and do something fun and different. This week's, last week we talked about how sketches and card samples and stuff for our different challenges are going to be chosen, and it's going to be a little different this year, so you can watch last week's episode to hear more about that. And this week I want to talk about the Mailroom Monday and Thankful Thursday posts. Those go up each week, and they do take up some space on the blog, and sometimes they get really long, sometimes they're really short, you know, all different ways. But I would like to do those once a month instead of once a week, because I have some other stuff I want to put on the blog, and I just want to make more room on the blog for it. Now, some of you I know are going to be heartbroken because you love seeing your name in lights on Thankful Thursday, and I'm still thankful for you every Thursday and every day, but I am going to do the Thankful Thursday report portion in a different way than I have done in the past. And I'm going to list everybody by state. So all of Virginia will be together. All of Arizona will be together. So you can look at that list and see if there's other people near you that you would like to get in touch with and maybe make cards with. So I thought that could be kind of fun. And I have someone lined up who is going to work on coordinating all of those people. So you'll be able to email into a certain place, fill out a little form, and say, I want to meet with this person, and they will do what they can to hook you up. Now, if you are one of those people that does not want someone to contact you, we are going to have a process for that too. So don't worry, I'll tell you more about it in 2013, but I just thought I would let you know. Mailroom Monday and Thankful Thursday will change a little bit. You will still get plenty of reports, but they will be in a different format. That's all. So this weekend, there's going to be a really important vlog, like a really, 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 really important vlog. And so I will be linking to that on the blog and on Facebook and on my blog and like all over the place because I want everybody to know about the other changes coming up, this other particular big one. And I want to do it from a script so I get it all straight and don't babble like I'm babbling right now. So watch for that this weekend. Might be tomorrow if I get it edited tonight. All right, next, Hero Arts. I did a video on the Hero Arts channel yesterday, and it was really fun. It was a technique that I don't know if I invented or if, you know, somebody else has done it maybe, and I just invented the name of it, but I called it Copic Resist. And it was a really fun video. It's already gotten 3,000 views. Holy cow. So it's pretty exciting. And so since we had done that, and I did that with OWH Hero Art Stamps, I thought I would do some Valentines with all of the Hero Art Stamps. There are 6 sets, if you did not know that. Pretty exciting. And we may have some new people here watching because I linked to it on the Hero Arts blog, so they might come here and watch the show. So welcome to you if you are coming here from Hero Arts. We'd love to have you with us. But I wanted to share 2 of my favorite comments that I saw on the Hero Arts either video or like one of them was on the video, and it said, yay, a face. Because a lot of people don't put their face on when they do a tutorial. And even though mine was weirdly colored because my lighting was really bad that day and I looked kind of yellow and peaked, she said, yay, a face. She liked seeing a face. So it was kind of fun. And another person on Facebook said something kind of funny. She said, I would probably watch a video of you reading from the phone book. I'm not really sure that that would be a really interesting video, but I promise you I will never sit and read from the phone book, at least not for a whole video. So there you go. So if you've not watched it, I will be linking to it at the end of this video so you can go watch that and see what that's like. Now, the card share. Since we are in Valentine's season, you wouldn't know that from my blog because I've been posting a lot of Christmas cards on my blog because I'm working on my personal Christmas cards and trying to get those done. But we are in Valentine's season. Christmas cards are done. Do not send us any more. If you can hold them till next summer, that would be great. I got more in the mail today. Eek! So please hold them. But we are doing Valentine's. Now, Valentine's can be, when we say Valentine's, we mean Valentine's and love cards. Because the way it works, if you picture, okay, there's a unit of 30 guys that we send a box to, and if we sent them 30 Valentine's, and only 10 of them have a girlfriend or a wife at home, what are they going to do with the other 20 Valentines? They may have a sister or brother or mom or dad to send it to, but maybe not. We don't really know. So instead of sending tons of them that say Happy Valentine's Day, we send half of what we think they'll use is Valentine's, and then part is love cards, because then the people who do have someone can use them later. They have a longer shelf life. So these cards are technically not Valentine's because none of the Hero Arts OWH sets say Valentine's Day. So I just did love cards with every single one of the sets, and it was a little stretch with a few. But let me show them to you anyway. All right, let me turn the other camera on. There we go. This is the Year-Round Sentiments set, and this is probably one of my favorite and most used sets. Because it's got so many sentiments in it. You can see these all at the Hero Arts website. They have a link to their Operation Right Home sets. But this one uses an art, let's see, what is it called? Deconstructing Gen sketch. I think it might be this week's. And I used, the heart is also part of the stamp set, and I think my lucky stars for you. Used some really fun patriotic papers. Yes, our heroes do like to get the red, white, and blue. They enjoy that. So I like kind of mixing it up sometimes and using some red, white, and blue on non-patriotic cards. So pretty fun. Next, let's go to one of the newer sets. This one is from Epic Love. And Epic Love has this wonderful globe in it. And what on earth did I think of all the time before you? And what I did with it was stamp the earth and the you, and I popped those in red so that they would be popped or and match the color of the little red heart that I punched out and added onto this. And this is just the same stamp here made as a background on a piece of paper that was already distressed. So kind of made a sort of masculine-ish kind of card, guy card. This one is clean and simple, goes right back to the beginning, one of the first sets called Right at Home, and has this really fun little kite on it. And this is actually, it's paper pieced, but, oh, come on, light. Do it right. Oh, it's getting kind of weird and dark and blue. I don't know if you can see the crazy color. Anyway, I did stamp this, the diamond of it, and I trimmed it out. But these are not two separate pieces. I just took two of the pieces and I drew polka dots on them so that it looks like it's two pieces pieced together, but it's only one piece pieced together. But I did it first. I stamped the kite and the clouds first, and then I did the paper piecing on top. So then I didn't have to worry about the clouds going over top of the kite. So a little bit of love flying through the air. We'll jump forward to one of the later sets, and this one got a little bit on the crazy side. I was trying to create a focal point here with some stickers that I had from Basic Gray, and you know, kind of combined them together. You can see there's hearts and this big swirly thing. This strip is also from the set, and I made the sentiment. I put it on my block in a sort of a wave and trimmed it out that way. And then the balloon itself from the Happy Birthday set is paper pieced onto some paper. And this is actually cut out from the same paper. I just colored with my Copics over top of it to make this band and to color the ribbon. So you can see a little bit of the chevron pattern through it, but at least I didn't have to then cut out a separate piece of ribbon for that little element. So it was a little less paper piecing because I did it that way. And here is the All the Time set. And I got this idea from somebody who sent one in that was clean and simple and just had that strip on it and a little sentiment. But you know me, I like to put a lot of layers, a lot of crazy things on my cards. So I used one of the really fun sentiments that go with it, looking forward to spending time together, and added a few hearts. So this would be a really nice masculine card for somebody to send home to their hubby. And any one of these cards could have Happy Valentine's Day stamped on the inside, but if you do that, please make sure you put it in your Valentine's section in your box so that your shippers know that it's a Valentine and should go out on time for Valentine's Day. And then this one was from Winter Wishes, and I decided to make it clean and simple. I started with this snowman, little guy down here. Come on, camera, focus. And I wanted him to peek out from the bottom of it. You can see there's some little white snow that I added on with puffy paint. But he wasn't showing up against the white, so I just added the pink panel behind him and made some snow on it with a white pen. And I think it came out kind of fun. And kept it fairly simple. This ribbon is also from May Arts, and it's just this long strip of hearts. And you're going to see me using that more because I have a whole spool of it that I need to start using up. So that is six cards from six Hero Art sets. And guess what? There's more coming! I can't wait! They said they're going to maybe do three more sets. So we're going to have some more fundraiser sets out there. I'm so excited. And I can't wait to see what they come up with to do. I sent some ideas in, but I don't know what they're gonna decide to. So cross your fingers for some really fun stuff. Let me see. I see somebody saying maybe it's time for another state shout-out on Facebook. That might be a good idea to do tomorrow. Fridays are always a good day for that. Let's see. Boo, 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 boo. Hero Arts video was great. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. Reading from the phone book. Yes, I would not be reading from the phone book, but I'm glad I'm that much fun to watch. I'm scrolling through comments for those of you who don't know. There's comments live during the show. And Let's see. Diana says, I do need the URL. So on Thursdays, I will be posting the URL, or I will post it on Wednesdays. I might add it to the Wednesday midweek throwdown. So whatever post is going to come up, depending on what days we decide to post other things. If there's another post going up on Thursday, I just want to try to keep from having too many posts for no reason. So if I can combine it maybe with the Wednesday post and give that link to Jan, and then we'll put that in there each week instead of adding it elsewhere. Or, I could add it to the sidebar of the blog, and then it's always there. How cool is that? Because I could set them up. I can set them up ahead of time and get like, okay. All right, thinking through things live as we go. Craziness. Okay, so that is the card share for today. Thank you to Hero Arts for featuring me on the blog and letting me play along. Got some more fun stuff, of course, coming up with them, as always. And tomorrow there's video going up on the May Arts channel, so you might want to check that out. So there's another one coming there. Let me see. Love your haircut. Thank you very much. I did actually get it cut recently, and I also colored it, so I'm not as gray as I usually am. I see people smartly already posting their numbers for the Stump Sandy segment, which is next. And the way we do that is we take these pieces of paper down to my handy-dandy OWHTV box. We have pieces of paper that people have sent in. They go in these little envelopes, and the envelopes are numbered, and then they shout out numbers. We pick randomly from those numbers, and I have to make a card with whatever comes out of these envelopes. And I don't know what it is, so it can sometimes be a train wreck. It's hard to know that. So maybe while a few more people are posting numbers... where is it? I don't know where it is. I got a note somewhere here. Oh, there it is. I see it. I wanted to point out the flag behind me. Do you see the flag behind me? That is a new flag. We had another flag up there earlier, but I took that to the office because we were using it for our Veterans Day event. And I have a new flag up there, and it says, just wanted to say thank you for all you do. I had a flag flown on 9/11/2012 in your honor. I hope you like it. And that is from our friends at the USO in... Let's see, where is she at? She's in Afghanistan. I just don't remember which base because she's moved recently to a different base. But anyway, it's from Afghanistan, so thank you very much for the flag. Okay, now on to Stump Sandy. Now there's more numbers there. Just going to randomly scroll through the thing and see what number my little mouse lands on. And I see a 29, a 12, and a 26. Okay. 12. 29 and 26. We have our three selections, and we will find out what is going to be happening next. What are the three pieces of paper? Dun, dun, dun. Let's see what's in here. We have, looks like some masculine paper. Next. Okay, we have some polka dots. It doesn't quite match. That could actually work a little better, maybe, sort of. We'll see what's in the third one. Uh-oh. Okay, now we got some serious troubles. Woo boy. I am guessing we're going to be doing some distressing here. Wowzers. Now these two could go and work better together, and then this could be an accent. Or I could focus on these two and do that one as an accent. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. What on earth am I going to do? I think I need to think about it. What do you guys think? Is there anybody in chat that has any preference on whether we go with a more masculine look with these? Or do we put this over here and go for something more feminine? Anybody got a preference? And I will tout my mug. I have this awesome Operation Right Home mug. Christmas is coming. Be sure to put some OWH stuff from our swag store in your Santa Claus list. Kathy Press, look for Operation Right Home there. Little plug. Okay, I don't see anybody there on chat. Well, I mean, I'm sure you guys are trying to leave comments, but YouTube is a little slow. Okay. All right. I am juiced up now with my lemonade. And we will see. I think I'm going to go for the masculine because we get so many feminine cards. I want to see if I can push this in a masculine direction.
Which means distressing.
And I'm going to get out my distress ink and my distress tool. And I have this one that has a different pad on the end of it. One of our card makers made these out of wool, and they stick to this stuff just like anything else would, but they're bigger than the pad. I really like that about them. So these don't really need distress, but this one is going to need some treatment to make it work. So I think I'm going to start with treating that and seeing what I come up with first before I decide what to do with the card. So I'm going to take a piece of scratch paper and just start doing some overall distressing and see if I can just push this to be more of a brown paper. Because if I can get rid of that pink feel that it's got going on, then I might be happier with it. But I don't know what it's going to take to push it into the pink realm, or out of the pink realm and into browns. It's better. Still not great. All right, I'm going to try to be a little bolder. This pad is really dry, so if you have one of these pads and you're going to try doing direct to the paper, be really careful if you like the paper that you're trying to mess with, because you can very well make a giant mess out of it with big blotches of ink. This one is, like I said, dry enough, which is probably why my distressing tool is not picking up enough ink to actually do anything to it. And I think I'm going to try a two-tone distressing. So now that I've got some of the brown going on, these have blues and greens in them. So, crash! Well, is everybody okay? I had a block that fell off of my little shelf up here. Hope you are all doing all right there, that nobody got a little freaked out by the giant crash there. Oh, I hear somebody saying turn it over. It's white on the other side, so that will be an option if I don't really have any success with distressing the daylights out of this paper. But I want to see if I can do it first. I don't know what the green is going to do. Green plus the pink might actually turn into more of a brown. So it might actually work. Although, no, if I use a small enough piece of it, then I can probably get away with it anyway. But yeah, this is actually working a little bit better than the brown, probably because my pad's a little juicier. I think I need to get a new one or re-inker and get that brown one fixed up. So we are changing the overall tone of this. If you're going to do something like this, you want to go for the opposite on the color wheel. That's one of the reasons I went for the green and the pink. I'm not sure if they're exactly opposite, but the two colors together turn into a more neutral kind of color. As you can see, sort of disappearing from that whole pink family. Although I guess it might still look pink because the light's a little bit blown out on the camera, but it's certainly better than it was, and that at least brings it into the right family of colors. So now to figure out what else to do with it is the question, because I wonder if I do a small bit of that and then a small bit of that on top of that. I think that's what I'm going to do. All right. So I'm going to go for a 3x4 kind of piece of this. But then I want to cover up a lot of it because I just don't want a whole lot of that stuff showing through. So I'm going to go for a larger piece of this, but it's a matter of layout. And thinking through my layout here in some way. Do, do, do. Do-do-do. Think.
All right. If I go...
and a half that way. Do something like that and then start working with my layering behind it all. And the colors I want to pull out are going to be either greens or blues. I think greens are going to be more common between them, so I think I'm going to use that for my layering.
Yes, shock. I'm not using black or brown.
I think brown would actually be a lot easier to do and would come out more quickly in getting the card to be completed. But I'm going to get, oh, wait a minute. Oh, wow. Oh, I like that so much better. Oh, I love that. Why did I not turn that paper? Well, I guess I turned it over before. I just wasn't looking particularly much. That's nice. That still needs a little distressing if I do that, though. But I love that this starts popping against that now. Yay! All right. So I'm going to add my ATG tape. And the show did start a couple seconds late because I was refilling my ATG tape. I finally remembered to do it prior to the show. Make sure I had it ready to roll. And I think I might need to shave off a slice of this so it actually fits a little bit better. There we go. So I'm going to use a panel of this color, this crazy wacko thing. And, whoops, whoa. Hold everything up here. So you know the ATG tape, if you get it too close to the sides, ends up sticking out. So what I do is just kind of run my finger along the back of it and sort of roll the tape that's sticking out of the sides and sort of roll it back underneath. Because if you press the thing down, then you're going to have to rub it off the front. And it's a lot easier to just knock it to the back than to have all that sticky on the front of your card. Because it does get sticky and then we get piles of cards that stick together and it kind of turns into a bit of a mess. So now this panel is a little bit on the bright side. So I am going to darken it up a little bit. I don't know if the green is going to do it. Oh yeah, I think it will. I just want to soften it a little bit more because it's a little too graphic. You know, just, it's not totally clean. It's a little bit distressed of paper, but it's got such straight circles and they're so clean that I want to make sure I dirty it up like the other papers so that it kind of feels like they're in the same sort of family of papers. And in addition to the green, and this is peeled paint, I'm going to add a little bit of orange. Now this is again going for the opposite color because that's going to brown it out a little bit more. I'm not sure if I'm using the word opposite even correctly here. I don't want a lot, so I'm going to rub off the excess here. And then I can add just a little bit of it to the paper, because then it's going to add a brown tint just in some spots. I don't need the whole thing to be all brown, but I want to push part of it color-wise in that direction. So now I have that panel ready. Now it's got a ding in it right here. Looks like the paper had a little bit of a hole in it, but that's fine because it's distressed anyway. So I'm going to adhere this. And look, I'm not going to use layers behind this one. And one of the reasons is because this piece of paper is going to actually show up against the papers that are under it. A lot of times we get papers that you're not going to see the thing that's under it because they're too close in tone. And this one is going to show up. And one of the reasons I like this dark paper is because this is going to show up against this. The two of them are going to balance each other out nicely. And I'm trying to line up roughly so that I have the same distance here, here, and here. It is going to leave me with some extra over here, but that's space for embellishing. I love having space for embellishing. Now I have this stamp, and I was doing this, and I was thinking about this stamped piece of paper that I've had sitting on my desk. I was going to use it, and I just never got around to it. But I am going to use it on this one because it's got the same kind of feel as the rest of this in the stamping. And all I have to do is distress it the same way I did these others. And I can create all of them having that same kind of feel. So I'm going to start with a little bit of that orange color that's still on my little pad here. I don't want to go real dark, but I want to go enough that it doesn't look like this bright white light thing that it started out as. So I'm going to add a little bit of green to these edges. Oh, 701. I gotta get rolling. I know you guys are patient and you don't close out on me, but I like to respect your time given that this is a work night and try to finish up on time. Oh, dog hair. Or is that sandy hair? Huh. Somebody's gonna get a little extra piece of me. Alright, now this one, I think I'm gonna pop a little bit. And I wanted to show you that we get to retire the old Precious. The old Precious is gone. Look at her. Goodbye, old Precious. We should probably play taps or something, but I think she's just going to go into the ether. And here is the new Precious. Welcome, new Precious. Yay! New Precious. Love to have more of her handy, because what would happen in my life if I couldn't use some dimensional adhesive on something. And I always remind people that when you use dimensional adhesive, the thinner you can use, the better. You can use a lot of it, because that doesn't add a whole lot to it, but using at least the thinnest that you can, and I find that the Precious is a really good, it sticks really well, but it also is really thin-ish. It's not like the big towers of those little tiny squares. And so they work really well. Let's see, I'm going to do this about here. Because I'm going to leave myself a little bit of room for some quick embellishing. Very quick. Now my debate is if I'm going to go for something light and use like pearl pen dots, or am I going to go with something dark? And I think I'm going to do the dark, because they're going on this lighter color, and I want this to be the only spot of light on the card. I think that will actually work pretty well. I'm going to test this on a piece of scrap. For those of you who use pearl pen on any regular basis, you know if you get an air bubble in there, everything's going to go splat. So I tend to try to try it out a little bit on a piece of scrap before I get going. So a little bit of lines of that, and, oh, debate. Does it need a heart? I don't know. What do you think? I feel like it needs ribbon, but I think that might be too much because I'm trying for a guy card. However, I do have, oh, if it's here, I had a little scrap of ribbon. That would have been a perfect, there we go. A scrap of ribbon that I'd actually tossed because it was just this little piece, but it's in the same green colors. So I think I'm going to use just one little piece of it and not go overboard with ribbon. Use a glue dot and I'm going to glue down the end, one end, right under here. This is, you know, it's not necessary on the card to always have ribbon, of course. You know, even me, I have made cards without ribbon. but sometimes it just adds a tiny enough piece of detail that it makes a huge difference to me in the final impact of the card. So then I'm just going to stick the other piece down here. And then I've got just a little bit of extra detail without a whole lot added onto the card. Hold that up so you can see better. And this will be posted on the blog later tonight once I get it stuck onto the card base. So, ta-da! Stump Sandy! I'm glad you guys like this Stump Sandy thing because I enjoy it. It's a creative challenge for me. For those who may not know, I'm a graphic designer by day, and I love things that just push me a little outside of my regular creating box. So, it's kind of fun. Anyway, thank you very much for watching the show. I really enjoyed having you all here. I have a little giveaway, of course, for those who have stayed all the way to the end. Lucky you. And I have, where is it? My final two giveaway sets that Hero Arts gave me of two of our stamp sets. We have the Epic Love set, which makes these great masculine cards. And we have the balloons with the Happy Birthday set. Final two, that's the last ones left to give away. What do you have to do to qualify to win one of these? Let me see. I think I wrote something down. I want to know, do you still shop at those card stores like Hallmark? I think that there are crafters who secretly go there and they buy cards for people that are not like somebody they want to actually make a card for. But I find that they're so expensive that I'd even rather make a yucky card for somebody like that. So it was a really anomaly for me to go to Hallmark, but I'd like to know if you secretly sneak in there once in a while and buy a card. Do you ever have to do that? And do you feel like you're cheating on your craft supplies? Because I totally did. Except I can't buy this thing I needed. Or I can't make this thing I needed. I didn't buy it. So anyway, leave me a comment and let me know about your secret card shopping adventures. And that could even include, actually, if you go to Etsy and buy things. Do you buy any of your cards on Etsy? Because I'd like to know if you make them or you buy them. All right, thank you so much. Have a fantastic Thanksgiving. I am going to see you on the other channel on a vlog and maybe on another video or two, depending on what I end up doing next week. Who knows what's going to come up next week because I got a ton of stuff to share. I will see you on the May Arts channel tomorrow, so you want to watch that. And I will put the Hero Arts link right here after I get this video uploaded to YouTube. And then I will put, what is I going to put? The vlog. Once the vlog goes live, I will put it right here so that if you're watching the show and you want to get to that special vlog that's coming up this weekend, just know it's not going to be up there quite yet. So once the clicky button shows up, you can only click on those things when you're on a desktop computer. So if you're on your phone, that won't work. Okay. See you guys!